Welcome to another wonderful episode of Cat Chef Kitchen. We have Autumn Love here today. And I don't know if we have anyone tuned in yet, so I'll introduce you a couple times, Autumn. Maybe I'll explain why you're... Oh, there's Brock. Hey, Brock.
Hi, Brock.
Autumn is going to be taking over for today. I had a minor injury yesterday, so it's best that I do not show my face at the moment. I might sound a little weird when I'm talking, but I think the way we're going to do this is I'm going to help guide Autumn through a more liquid meal. That's due to my injury. I have to be on some liquids. So we're going to do some vegan post-dental slash facial operation cooking today.
I think that's really good for anyone that may ever have to go on a liquid diet, you know? Maybe people are blessed and never have to, but maybe someone may have to 20 times in their life. So
yeah.
Helpful.
So we're doing the special liquid vegan episode. And Autumn, you're gonna be our cook, and I think this is gonna be fun too, because hopefully you always have good questions, and hopefully you have some more good questions as you're doing everything. Am I wired? What does that mean?
I'm wired.
Am I wired?
I don't think you're wired.
Wired?
Just injured and sewn up a little bit.
Oh, wired as in like medically?
I'm not sure.
Well, I have a couple stitches on my lip and I guess got a tooth replaced, so.
and he still looks beautiful.
Wired shut. No, I'm not wired shut. My mouth wired shut. Slightly.
Yeah.
I could turn the camera around so people can
I'll
see.
Show
it's not too bad.
I'll show him.
So I had a minor skateboard to the face injury. So some stitches, replacement tooth, and some other tooth cracking. Hopefully we address everything. And I just have to be on this liquid diet for 2 weeks while things heal. So that's why I'm not hosting today. And all right, let's get started. We already know what we're making, right?
Yes.
What are we making, Autumn?
We are making a broccoli cheese soupy thing. I'll just say it's more inspired by me. Well, initially, because that was my favorite soup. But I don't really have dairy, and you need to have liquids, so we thought it'd be a good kind of inspiration for something to jump off of. And we've never done that. I don't think we've ever cooked with broccoli, even in general.
Yeah. On Cat Chef.
On Cat Chef, mm-hmm. Yeah. So I think that's good.
Yes.
Yes.
And Brock, yep, I did not fracture my jaw. It's just a minor injury. All right, Autumn, let's get started.
Okay, so we have red lentils that we already prepped. We chose those, as anyone remembers, Cat Chef does a vegan cheese with red lentils, specifically because they get a little more mushy of a consistency, so it'll be good for the cheese that we're gonna do for one of the bases for the soup. We have a couple other bases. We also have some oat milk in the fridge that we made, which Bo helped guide me with the oat milk we just had. I put 1 cup of oats with 4 cups of water and let it sit overnight. And then we put it in the food processor and just let it go for minutes. And so that's a really good milky consistency also to add to the soup. Please, Bo, chime in. I don't even know what I'm
saying.
You're
doing great.
Say whatever I need to say.
You're doing great.
So we have the lentils, red lentils.
Mm-hmm.
Which only really cook for like not even 10 minutes, right? 10 minutes?
Maybe? Yeah, it's like maybe 15 minutes.
Okay.
You just boiled them with some water.
Till they're tender.
Mm-hmm.
And then my sous chef Bo here has chopped up some potato. This just an organic. Are they russet potatoes, Bo?
Organic russet potatoes.
In kind of the usual size we also do for breakfast potatoes.
Mm-hmm.
So we have these.
Parents. They say hi.
No, I don't even know if I washed my hands. I just touched that. I did earlier.
Yeah, you're
no,
good.
No, I did just wash my hands. I'm going to do it again, though.
That's good.
Hi, parents of Bo. I'm going to try not to say anything super funny because it's really painful for Bo to smile, and anyone that knows him, he is just smiling and laughing the whole time. He's always saying to squeeze a smile, and it always improves your mood, so I actually should try to be very serious during this.
No, smile.
Oh, okay.
Smiling is good. You have a beautiful smile.
Okay, so we have the potatoes. We have a yellow onion, this beast of an onion. I snuck in a little habanero. Don't know if that's gonna happen, but hopefully. And then I don't know if spice is good for your mouth, Bo. I'm not sure.
Yeah,
we probably shouldn't do spice.
Hold off
on
that.
And then we have broccoli, which I rinsed off. Nice organic broccoli. And we also have some vegetable broth, which I was asking Bo when we were shopping, what's the difference between broth and stock? I saw vegetable broth and vegetable stock, and I really don't know what it is.
I don't know either, so I have to look that up. I thought they were the same. I don't think there's a difference, but I could be wrong, so.
Who knows? So we have that, and anything else? I feel, you do this.
I do.
Just instinct. I'm just taking the role.
Wow, you're just filling my shoes perfectly.
Whatever this is. So, anything else we need to prep or clean? So, I'm a little different cook, although I am going to be very spontaneous like Bo is. However, I'm more of someone who wants everything washed, everything chopped, everything out, everything measured, ready to go prior to even doing any of the actual cooking. I like all prep and then cook. So I'm kind of asking Bo for this reason. Is there anything else that I should rinse off? We should pull out of the fridge?
Well, let's get some stuff out of the fridge.
Okay.
So we can kind of lay out everything that's going to be going into our little broccoli cheddar vegan soup thing.
Okay.
So the first thing in broccoli cheddar soup is the broccoli.
Yes.
And the second thing is the cheddar. So we got the broccoli taken care of right there. Now let's take care of the cheddar. And to do that, let's start here. So I lied, we're not going to the fridge first.
Okay.
We're going to the lentils first. And we're going to need the food processor because we're going to be making our vegan cheese. And the food processor is already prepped right by the spice cabinet. That's when someone plans. That's why Autumn's good, because she plans out. Plans things out location-wise. So our kitchen geography is mise en place. Did I say that correctly? Yes, Autumn's very good with that. Salt Panda. We're gonna need some garlic powder and onion powder, nutritional yeast, some olive oil, some soy sauce, and, you know, I've been recently adding a little tiny bit of turmeric to the cheese because I kind of like the effect that that has.
I forget, do we add salt?
We're going to need salt for sure.
Salt Panda or the real salt?
We're going to use the big salt because that can get out a lot of salt. Yeah, Salt Panda is good for the finishing.
This is actually the fake salt because it's cinnamon salt.
Cinnamon salt.
It's not really. We just reuse every container. Ever.
We do. We try and reuse as much as possible.
Okay.
And we don't really need any, I think we're going to leave smokiness out of this. We're not going to do any smokiness.
Okay.
Keep it more traditional. So no smoked paprika, no no chipotle. So let's start. We got a lot of lentils here. This is really interesting. I'm not usually on this side. It's kind of fun to help create through, like, as a team. So I think we should just add a bunch of those lentils into, normally we do about like a cup, but we want this really cheesy. So this is going to be the primary base, I think, for our soup.
Is that enough or more?
That looks like a good amount. And that's probably 2 cups of lentils, I think.
I would agree.
Cool.
Okay. And it's already kind of mushy. I mean, I seriously just pushed it with my spoon just to show you what it's doing. I mean, it's already doing what we want it to do. This is why red lentils are so great for cheese.
Yeah. If you do not like to do beans and lentils or legumes of any sort, you can do potato in its place. You can boil some potatoes or saute some potatoes so they get really soft and throw them in place of the red lentils here. But it would be good to probably identify another protein source, although we are using nutritional yeast, and that is a great protein source.
So let's throw some of this in.
Yeah, we're gonna need some of that for sure, so.
How much?
Let's add about 1/4 cup. It's a pretty decent amount.
I'm gonna go for the big opening here.
Yep.
It looks like fish flakes. Good, more?
That looks good. Start.
Okay.
Now let's add about 2 tablespoons just a heaping tablespoon of garlic powder and onion powder.
A heaping tablespoon.
A little bit more. That looks good.
I always forget about this other side.
And that looks good. Perfect. Now we're gonna do about 1 teaspoon of turmeric. That's good. Now we're gonna do about 1 teaspoon or 2 teaspoons of soy sauce. This is for that savoriness. That's good. And now olive oil. Definitely we need some olive oil. So usually this would probably be about 1/4 cup of olive oil. Cheese, a big component of cheese is definitely fat. So want to add that in. That looks good to start. We could always go back and tweak some of this. Now salt, do a couple shakes of salt, not too much. That's good. All right, let's give that a mix. Oh wait, I forgot one thing. Vinegar, because we need some tang to everything.
Tang. I never really ever knew to ever use this in my life for cooking. It was always in my household growing up as more of a cleaning agent and never, or like dyeing eggs. I never even knew to cook with it. Okay, how much of this?
Let's go 1 or 2 tablespoons. That's good. All right, now we're gonna mix it up. So while that's going, we could probably get started on the veggies and building our soup base.
Okay.
So we can turn this off now. It looks pretty smooth.
I have a quick question.
Yeah.
Can you over food process this?
No.
Like, if I let this go for 2 minutes, would it do anything?
I don't think so. Okay. It might. I don't know. You might have to check on your food processor to see how long that can run for. But food-wise, it's just going to get smoother and smoother the longer you let it run.
Okay.
That's actually the key to making like homemade nut butters, is just letting it run really long, because if you don't, it's just going to be kind of a chunky nut butter.
Look how pretty it is.
It looks great. So now you're going to give that a taste?
I get to taste all the food now. Yeah. This is great.
What does it need? What is it missing?
Oh,
what
this
stuff
is what
too
I'm
much?
So bad at.
Mm.
This is why you cook. I want a little more cheesy. I want a little more nutritional yeast.
Okay.
And just a little bit of this.
Okay, and that is garlic powder?
Garlic. But I love garlic. This is actually for you, so it's kind of weird that I'm the one cooking it. And just a little bit of this.
And that was the soy sauce, by the way. Tamari is gluten-free soy sauce. It's made with soybeans only.
Okay. Broccoli or potato first, because they take longer?
We're going to do them about at the same time. Probably the potatoes first, actually.
Okay.
So what we're going to do is we're going to use this cast iron pan. It's pretty deep, and we're going to try and build most of our soup in there.
Okay.
Tap that off. I don't know how well people can hear while that's running. All right, let's see.
This smells really good.
That's good. It's a good start.
Mmm. I think it's good. It is kind of thick, but if we're adding a little bit of oat milk or something, it'll get a. I think that'll add a better consistency.
Okay.
I would say oil, but I don't think it flavor-wise needs more oil.
Okay.
So
maybe. Vinegar can also be used if you want it to be a little tangier. If it feels a little dull, vinegar is gonna make it. Like a brighter, tastes a little bit brighter.
I love that word for cooking.
Yeah.
Okay.
Start there. See where that gets you. You could always add more. Perfect. Then we can move on to the next step.
I think it's great. I think it's perfect.
This is going to get stirred in at the very end of our cooking of the soup.
Are we going to use the food processor for anything else?
We are, because we're going to need to transfer that out of the food processor, because this is going to be a totally thick, creamy soup that we're going for. There's going to be no chunks of anything.
Okay. Oh, so, right. So, okay. So do I heat this up first?
Yeah, we're going to heat that up over medium-high heat. Get some oil in that pan. And
much
for
more?
Yeah, we want to completely coat the bottom of that pan with oil. Maybe just a hair more. It's going to make a pretty decent amount of soup, so we don't have to worry about it being too greasy. And the oil is going to add some richness to the soup. For those of you just joining us, just want to reintroduce our guest host today, Autumn Love.
Hi.
She's taking over and making a vegan broccoli cheddar soup. And the theme of today is liquid meals, because sometimes you injure your face, like I have done, and you need to go on a liquid-only diet for a week or two.
But you still need to be nourished and have your balance of
exactly.
Your carb, protein, and veg.
Exactly.
So how do we do that?
So, we've got oil heating on the stove. Now we're going to add the potatoes. And I would say just throw one in right now. Just check on the temperature of the oil. And once that starts sizzling, we could even turn that up to a higher heat. We're going to wait for that to start sizzling. Once it starts sizzling, then we can add the rest of those potatoes. We could probably start chopping up the broccoli in the meantime, although that is probably going to start heating and sizzling pretty soon.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and another question. I have so many questions.
That's great.
I never know I hear it kind of sizzling. I never know how far down of the stem on the broccoli to use. Is it like good all the way down here? Do you do halfway? Like, is this more firm?
It's a little too woody and tough down at the bottom. I usually will go like halfway up because a lot of the stem is good, but I usually do like an inch or so off the bottom. And then another thing to do that's good is I usually chop it about here at kind of like the branches. Yeah. And then what I'll do is the outside of the broccoli tends to be really fibery and hard to eat.
Mm-hmm.
So I slice and like peel essentially the outside of the broccoli.
Okay.
But first, we hear our potato sizzling. We're actually going to leave it exposed for right now, because what we're doing right now, rather than just throwing this all in liquid and boiling it, we want to get browning to happen. We don't have to worry about these cooking thoroughly because they're going to boil. We just want things to get really nice and brown because that's where we get more complex flavor. And that's going to add to the goodness of our soup. And the broccoli doesn't have to be chopped super fine because we're going to end up processing
all of it. So you do like this?
Yep, exactly. And again, that just helps remove some of the tough to eat parts.
I wonder, Brock, do you like broccoli? Do you feel obligated because your name's in broccoli?
Oh, and Brock also asked, what's the carb tonight? The carb tonight is the potatoes. So that is our carb. I'm glad you asked that because we didn't mention that. The carb is the potatoes. That's going to be pureed into our soup. The protein is our lentils and nutritional yeast cheese. And the veg is going to be broccoli and onion. Cool beans.
Okay, so I don't have to chop it a lot?
No.
What does that mean? Like how big of pieces?
That looks good.
Like that?
Sure.
Smaller?
Maybe a little smaller. The stem of the broccoli usually takes a little bit longer to cook than the florets.
Cut it smaller.
So yeah, I usually like to cut the stem a little bit smaller
okay.
than the rest. And you can just start throwing that actually into the pot over here. So, and giving that a mix. It's best to use like a wooden spoon with cast iron so you don't scrape the bottom.
Can I just cut them?
Yep, that's perfect.
And should I wait or can I toss them?
No, you can start throwing them in. And I'm going to say actually split that and don't add the rest yet. We're going to do something else.
What do you mean by split this?
Just stop? Stop there.
Okay.
And then give it another little mix. And the reason for that is, it looks like our pan's getting pretty crowded. And we want to make sure everything gets the opportunity to get brown. If it's too crowded, things will just boil because there's so much liquid in these vegetables. So, what we're going to do is use this other pan over here to cook up our onion and the remaining broccoli so it can get brown in that pan.
Oh, that's fun.
And then we're gonna add it all to this pot And then we're going to add our cheese, and we're going to let it all kind of simmer together. Okay. Adding some olive oil, extra virgin olive oil. Love using this stuff. That's good.
So now I should add onion first?
Yeah, so now let's chop up some onion.
Question.
Okay.
I never know how many layers, like just this or the second piece too.
I like to peel back the second piece too, just because it gives an added layer of cleanliness, I think. I don't know where those onions have been. Could be pretty coarse as well. Yeah.
And go the other way?
Mm-hmm. Maybe just like four slices the other way. Let's do the whole onion. The temperature is still pretty high for the potatoes and broccoli. I'm gonna give them a little stir while she's cooking that. Every stove is different though, so you may need to turn yours down if it is really too high. All we want to happen is we want to start seeing little bits of brown happening, like right there. And like that potato, we want to see that getting brown. All right, we can start adding some of this. This is also on that's kind of medium high heat right now. That one's also medium high.
It's already full.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna end up with a lot of soup.
It's good because you might be on this diet for 1 to 2 weeks. Well, you are gonna be on it for at least a week.
Yeah. You can use a yellow onion, a sweet onion, a red onion, a white onion. It's really up to you. And stir that up a bit. All right. You have the rest of that broccoli to this other pan over here. Definitely crowding up these pans pretty good. Mm-hmm. Could even maybe start a third pan now that we have a whole collection of pans.
And this is cool, right? This is also a lid to this?
Yeah, so that is the lid. This pan is the lid for that pan.
Liquid diet, but I'm gonna like this.
Yeah? Good. It'll probably be served great with some nice fresh bread as well. Mm. All right, beautiful cheese, beautiful cheese over here.
Mm.
All right, that's looking pretty good. And I think if we added everything to this one pot, it wouldn't fit. So we might have to make this in batches. Or just make a smaller batch and just get out our biggest pot that we have. So, that's our biggest pot.
Turn this on?
No, not yet. We're gonna wait.
After this is done, they're all going in there?
Half of each of these.
Okay.
Because all of this is not going to fit in there, and it's not going to fit in the food processor, so we're going to have to do it in batches. So we're going to make...
I'll understand what's happening.
Yeah, you... All right. I think you can go ahead and add half of that to that pot now. And again, this pot in the back is actually not on. We're not turning this pot on yet. We're just kind of collecting all the ingredients here. Do you want a hand?
I'm not a complainer, but it's my one complaint about cast iron is it's so heavy. My little wrists just struggle.
Iris says hi.
You. Thanks for watching.
Hey, Iris. All right. See any browning going on there yet?
Not really.
Yeah, it might be a little overcrowded.
Okay.
So we'll give it a little bit longer.
Okay.
But in the meantime, and Brock said, are you going to put the potatoes and broccoli through the food processor to make it part of a liquid diet? Yes. All of this is going to go into our soup, and it's going to be a totally smooth soup.
Which you've never done this before, right? This is also an experiment?
This is pretty new, yeah. I've never done this recipe before. And this is just a good way to thicken up a soup naturally without using artificial thickeners. Or I guess they're natural thickeners too, but no guar gum or xanthan gum.
Can you just buy guar gum at a store?
I think you can. Some of them do have it somewhere.
What section would it be at a store?
I think the baking section,
okay.
Typically. Or gluten-free.
Like kind of a specialty section area?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. A little end shelf cap, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
I'm getting excited.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, that's great.
I'm hungry. I feel so bad saying that because Bo is just going to be hungry for the next 2 weeks.
Yeah.
So I even feel guilty eating in front of him. Like, it's just cruel to do, but... I'm embracing it. Bo knows I still have to eat. I can go on an all liquid diet with you.
Do you want to?
It'll be fun.
Wow.
People, you know, you mentioned you might lose weight from it. Like,
oh, I'm definitely going to lose weight.
If someone's wanting to lose weight, like if I want to lose weight, going on an all liquid diet, I could lose weight.
Yeah.
But... Even if I'm eating all the same things I eat anyways, it's just in a different consistency.
Yeah, well, it'll be an interesting experiment, because I think what we're going to find is that there's more liquid overall, and we're going to fill it more on water and have more filling from just water itself.
Okay. Are you wanting me to add some of that?
Yeah, and then we're going to actually need to transfer this. Let's actually transfer this out of here entirely. And not add directly to the other things yet. We got a lot going on. This is getting fun. This is weird for me, being on this side of the camera.
I know. Thank you for trusting me. I'm sorry. I'm not a real chef.
No, you're amazing. Autumn's a very, very good chef.
I guess I'm not a real camera woman either, so...
This doesn't have to get cleaned out perfectly because we're combining all this food. This is one of my favorite parts about using a food processor, when you're making things that mix together and you don't need to worry about cleaning the food processor in between. So you can have little bits of cheese residue because it's all going to go in anyways.
So like this or more?
Maybe a little bit more, like there's a big clump over there. Alright, that looks good enough.
Okay.
Look at that cheese.
Mmm.
Alright. Autumn also made these custom hot mitts. These are beautiful. I love this one because it says, I love you.
And there's a little heart.
And there's a little heart.
Okay, what's next?
Let's see if this is brown yet. Yeah, now we're starting to see some brown.
So brown is the trigger. Brown is the clue that it's approaching time.
Yeah, brown, when you see browning, it's going through the, it's getting caramelization, that's undergoing the Maillard reaction. Both those are different chemically reactions. Caramelization is the browning of sugars. The Maillard reaction is the browning of proteins. And I think I'm getting that right. And those both develop complex flavors, which are good.
Mm.
It makes it taste less watery, more savory, more interesting. My mom said, you're a good camera woman. I'm not sure if she's referring to me or you. I'm a little confused.
I don't think your mother would call you a woman.
Yeah, well, I don't know if he's saying that...
Filling in my shoes?
Yeah, filling in your shoes, or that you're good on camera, or what.
Okay.
But it's a compliment to both of us, let's just say.
Okay. Done?
Let's add half of that. We're gonna see what fits into the food processor.
Okay.
So the food processor, they generally say not to fill it more than halfway.
This?
Let's see.
Does it matter that it's hot?
Let's give it a little stir. We want to cool down just a little bit. I'm not a huge fan of throwing hot things in plastic things for our own health and well-being. Oh, but what we do need to do is we actually have to add more to this. We forgot our vegetable broth. So now, you can open up that, pour that into that pot.
You don't shake it or anything?
You probably should. I don't think shaking it's gonna hurt.
Okay, how much did you say?
Let's see where it gets us. Let's see how much. Yeah, that's a good start.
Okay.
And now I'm gonna turn that. That's actually okay. So I'm thinking through all of this as I'm instructing you. We're actually just gonna add that whole thing now to the food processor.
And that cool it down a little bit.
Exactly. And then we're going to heat it all up later. And we may not be able to do this all in one go, remember. And we're going to stir the cheese in later. So get it till it's about halfway. We're going to push the limits. We're going to maybe go. Yeah, that's good. If we go much more than that, it's just not going to work right. And it can leak out of the centerpiece. So we're gonna puree that until it gets nice and smooth. If you want a chunkier soup, you can leave it chunkier, but we're going for smooth. smooth? Looks like we could get a little smoother.
Still some chunk.
Yeah, we'll probably take that, let it process a little longer. We might need to let it process for like a whole minute, actually. Mm-hmm. So we want this, I've been kind of eating things through the straw, so.
That's the test.
Yeah.
You can go off the straw.
Let's go over here for a minute so people can hear us. Brock added in the difference between broth and stock. Oh. Is that broth is something you sip and stock is something you cook with. Okay. So you could sip on some broth.
Okay.
Might be fun to walk to a restaurant, like, what do you want to drink? You got any, what broth do you guys have in? What's on your broth menu? Is there any broth here? So, now, we're waiting for that. We've got our cheese. We're gonna need another pot. So let's use, can we use this one?
Yeah.
Oh wait, nope, it's full.
It's empty.
Oh. Or just a bowl, not a pot, but a bowl.
Bigger? What are we doing with it?
We're gonna put, we need to get this back into there, but we gotta get what's in there somewhere else.
Let's just pour that in here.
Perfect.
It's a musical pot.
My dad said, you're a good camera woman.
Me or you?
Well, it's funny because he commented that, but I'm the one filming, so.
Okay. Oh, I'm just getting it. So, the whole final soup is going in here.
Exactly.
I'm a little slow sometimes.
Oh, you're doing great.
Okay.
Check on it?
Better.
Might be good enough for us.
Do you want to do the straw test, Bo?
I think that's good. We're just going to start there. Let's just go for it. If people want it smoother at home, just know that you can get it smoother by processing it longer.
Okay, so this I'm putting in here now?
Yes, that's going to go in the pot. Out perfectly.
Right.
So we're gonna add, we've got plenty of room in this pot still, so we're gonna add some more of these. We're gonna do round two.
Think all of it can go in? We'll see.
Maybe not all of it, but
oh, am I supposed to add broth to it first?
You're okay for right now. We're gonna add broth again at the end to get it to the final consistency we want it.
Okay.
Maybe don't add all of that because it looks like it's a little full. That looks good.
No broth yet.
No broth yet.
Taste everything.
That's good.
You can like dance. If you know how to dance.
All right. Should we call it there? Could be smoother, but just for sake of moving things along.
But you have to eat it.
I could always puree a little bit more at the end too.
Okay.
Let's get our flavors good. Because these food, it can take a long time to get things pureed fully. And let's add, don't add all of it, but add about half of it. Perfect. Because we want to get our cheese balance good too. And I want to say we should just add this whole thing of cheese, this whole mound.
Right now in there?
Yep. Or maybe 2/3 of it to start.
Like that or more? A little more?
A little more, yeah. Maybe the whole thing, but...
Go for it?
Maybe just get the stuff that's hanging on the underside edge. Yeah. We could always add more of each of these things. Now you're gonna turn the heat on, medium heat, and you're gonna stir everything together. Is it on? It's important not to do this over a high heat when you're in a pot like this, because it could cause the bottom of the pan to burn. And if you think it feels too thick, which it might be a little thick right now, you can add more vegetable stock.
Are we doing oat or not?
Oh yeah, we have oat milk as well. Well, I could tell you, if you think, give it a taste, if you think it needs more creaminess, let's add more oat milk, or just oat milk period. We haven't added any yet. If it doesn't feel like it needs any creaminess, then add more vegetable stock. That's really good. Does it taste like broccoli cheddar soup?
Yeah. It does.
Remember, we can make
it. I haven't had broccoli cheddar soup since college. It's been over like 10 years since I've had broccoli cheddar soup. So I'm going back to the college dorm rooms, and I'd be so excited when there'd be broccoli cheddar soup. Do you want to try it, Bo?
I'd love to try it.
Should I get you a small spoon? Can you just lick this?
I can just lick that. Licking is good. Mmm. It's really good.
Yeah.
It like definitely tastes like broccoli.
Yes.
I get the flavor of broccoli.
Yeah. Obviously, it's a different kind of cheese.
Yeah.
I think I've honestly come to like your vegan cheese. It's so hard to say better than real cheese. It's such a weird thing. But if you're going by just flavor, I love the flavor of your vegan cheese. So even though it's a little different, it's just the idea of it.
Thank you. I think the one thing, it might be able to use more salt, but that's something that, like, not a lot. I'm hesitant. Does taste pretty flavorful.
Can you do it after in your own bowl?
Well, that's what I was just going to say. I think afterwards you can do it. But it's really up to whoever's cooking and whoever's eating to really decide on the salt, how much you're going to season it. And my dad asked, did you make your own oat milk? And we did. Autumn did.
We did. I'll just quickly say, Beau guided me and I did 1 cup of oats with 4 cups of water in a bowl, and we just left it overnight, although Beau said it doesn't have to be that long. And then I did it in two batches in the food processor because, again, it's not big enough to do it all, and just let it go and go. And I haven't even really tried it yet. You had it with a smoothie earlier?
Yeah. It was tasty in the smoothie. I have to try it plain. But yeah, what do you want to add? Do you want it to be more creamy? Do you want more vegetable stock? Or do you want it just that thick? Because if we add any liquid at this point, it's just going to thin it out more.
Well, I think that's part of why I liked broccoli cheddar soup, is it is a little bit of a thicker, creamier soup.
Mm-hmm.
And I like that about it. It's not super water-based. It is more of that creamy cheesiness. But my main concern is we're doing this for you and needing liquid.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe we should add a little bit more. I think it's your call, Bo, if you think you can eat it.
Mm-hmm.
'Cause flavor-wise, it's good. It is a little thick.
Yeah, it's like kind of a cross between mashed potatoes and soup, or like a chowder.
Yes, it's right in between.
So maybe you should add just a little bit more so it's a little bit runnier.
Okay, the stock, correct?
Stock or oat milk? It's up to you.
I kind of want to add oat milk.
Right? That sounds fun.
Okay.
But maybe we should just have a glass each as well.
Give it a little stir.
Yeah, I'm curious. Did you put it through a filter or did you just do it raw and are all the oats in the bottom of it still?
Oh, there's no filter.
Okay.
I didn't know.
Well, I don't do it through that. Well, all the oats are gone. There's no oats in there, right? Yeah, no, that's perfect. If you want it smoother, like with almond milk, you can put it through like a sieve or some sort of filter. But I like it. I like it thick.
Okay.
A little bit more. That's good. Just to start.
Did you want a glass?
Yeah, I'd love to have like a little glass of oat milk. That's good. Thank you. Let's see what it tastes like. I need a straw.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Here, I cleaned some.
I just realized that. Put it against my lip and I was like, whoops. Nice metal straws. Straws are actually one of the worst things environmentally, like the disposable ones. They're really hard to recycle and clean and they just are a mess. So I can make it look like you guys are all drinking right now. But
We have this really handy straw cleaner. It works so good. It works so good.
Oh, it's good. Okay. So refreshing. It's kind of like a milkshake that's not super sweet. One thing that I like to do, I'm gonna make myself a little treat out of here. Little mini takeover for a second.
I love when you do this.
I'm gonna take a little bit of vanilla extract. And like just the tiniest little splash.
Maybe you should do it.
Okay. Let's see if I can do this.
Wait for it.
Alright. That was a little bit more than normal that I'd recommend, but. And then maple syrup. And this is kind of like a healthy version of a milkshake, if you can say that even. Kind of low on both of those things, I guess. You can also use agave or any other sweetener. We definitely prefer maple syrup as our sweetener. Just give it a little mix. That's like a little vanilla milkshake. That's so good. You should have some. Yeah.
That's delicious.
It's amazing, actually.
Wow. Yum. Okay. like the consistency better.
Yeah, it looks good.
It's only a little bit more. I mean, we could add a little more, but what do you think, Bo?
I think that's doable. I definitely want more on the thicker side because it's just more substantial.
Okay.
I've been feeling hungry all the time since I've been on this liquid diet. Or at least a little weaker.
So, soup's done. Do you want to taste the flavor of it?
Mm-hmm.
You want to throw a straw in here or you want to just lick it?
I'll lick. Although I may have my soup through a straw.
What do you think?
It's good. It's really good. Just nice and like... It just tastes like a veggie soup that's creamy.
Yeah.
Like it doesn't taste like it's just melted cheese. Like the broccoli cheddar soups I've had in the past where it's just like this is basically like just a big pot of cheese, of molten cheese and cream sauce. Mm-hmm. This is like a nice... refreshing. There's a refreshing element to it.
More balance.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot more balance. That would actually be some of my disappointment with, not to say regular, but I'll just say regular broccoli cheddar cheese, is I would want more broccoli.
Mm-hmm.
I would always be like, where's the broccoli in this? So, okay. So I think that's done. We don't need to show everyone us doing another batch. They already kind of saw it go down.
Mm-hmm.
And... everything's in one pot.
Everything's in one pot.
This is amazing.
The carb, we got the potatoes as the carb, we got the lentils as the cheese, and we have the broccoli and onion as our veggies.
It's delicious. Do you want me to put it in instead of plating it, can I bowl it for you?
Yes, I'd love to have some in a bowl. You could stir in some nutritional yeast and salt if you want a little bit more cheesy or salty. Your timing was perfect. We're at 59 minutes right now.
Our timing.
That looks good.
Good to start.
Good to start off.
I'm really messy though. If the camera wasn't on me, I'd lick around the whole bowl.
My mom says I think it needs to be in a love mug.
You know, I was actually kind of considering that.
Yeah.
I know you want the quantity though. A bowl.
Do it in a love mug. I can do have multiple love mugs.
Do you want a love mug?
We'll just do the demo on.
Okay.
Podcast.
Demo. Right. Are you gonna straw demo as well?
You're not gonna demo?
Oh. Sure.
I could straw demo.
I think we should straw demo. You want me to take over and let you straw demo?
You get the final verdict here.
Mm. I think it's delicious.
Perfect.
It's great. Very good. Very easy. No chewing needed. I think it falls under the liquid
That's
category
the key.
For you.
As long as I don't have to chew.
As long as it can just go. I think it's good.
Looks
it's really
good.
Delicious.
Looks good. It's like a nice tennis ball hue.
Tennis ball. Okay.
All right.
That's it. This is kind of the... What's your word to use? The community? We kind of just plopped it all. It's
this
just
is
like
the building.
The melting pot.
This is the fortress.
The fortress.
Fortress versus community.
There's no layering, though. It's just one. We are all one.
Yeah, this is the swimming pool.
This is the... That's a good one.
Okay. The hot tub.
Okay. Anything else?
I think that's it.
Okay.
We did great. If there's any, it doesn't look like there's any questions from our viewers. So I'll let you close it off. Our guest host, Autumn Love.
Thank you for being with us and putting up with my our little makeshift, me hosting here at Cat Chef Kitchen, where we go live at 6 p.m. every Sunday. Even when we have an injury and go to the ER, we still show up for you. Because regardless of the state we're in, we need to nourish ourselves, right? We still need food, no matter what's going on. This is... May your food be your medicine. So.
Brock says, nicely done, Autumn.
Thanks, Brock. Thanks for watching. I think that's it, unless I'm supposed to say anything else, Bo.
That's it. All right, everyone. Thank you for watching.
We'll see you next Sunday at 6 p.m.